you got to learn. People do things at times, you know what I mean? And you got to kind of chill a little bit
You
because he
like
was
Jones
going,
in for me though?
baby, I didn't
Like
have
if
to.
I was like if I left, you wouldn't
I
have
didn't
been
have to
like,
Jones though.
you
No,
wouldn't have
no,
like
no.
been playing like
Now look, I know,
Speakeasy. You
no.
wouldn't have played Luther outside my window? Wait.
No, I'm not gonna be in bushes. I'm not.
You know, huh?
I already told you about that before.
I think that's a
Like
lie.
I said, we all learn from past mistakes. I ain't crazy. But I was just curious. The one I was wondering what she was doing. That's all.
You in bushes?
We meet, baby.
I slid in your DMs.
Why?
I wasn't sliding in a bunch of people's DMs. Don't look at me like that.
You sure?
I'm sure.
Okay. Okay. I was a little nervous at first.
My goddaughter,
Maddie.
Maddie, was like, "You should DM him." And I was like, "I'm gonna do it." And I remember I was in the car. She was driving. She was like, "Oh my God, you really
Now, you know
DM."
that's why Maddie my favorite, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can't replace Maddie.
Yeah, because she brought you the biggest gift that's ever
Possible.
been given to you.
Absolutely. Sexy one too.
Okay, so why did you respond?
Yeah, so you had some cool little glasses on. I said, she cute. You know, but I like the substance you had though. You know, I could tell you was kind of serious. So that's why I responded.
Okay.
Besides the yellow dress.
The yellow dress, I was gonna say, it wasn't my booty.
It was your booty. I'm like, damn, I saw your ass. I'm like, hold on. Let me go ahead and respond. I mean, that was a small percentage of the reason why I responded, though.
Thank you, mustard dress.
That mustard dress was—it was going. That mustard dress was on point.
Okay, so I was really excited for you to watch Love Jones because you haven't seen it. Finally saw it. Tell me, what did it make you feel? Did it make you laugh? Did it make you cry? Did it make you upset? Did it make you romantic?
I know what that means. It's a jab. I'm learning to be more romantic, okay? So, that's a jab. I got you.
It
It didn't make me sad at all. It gave me like mixed emotions.
Okay.
And I feel Darius, he was just so, I mean, they were very attracted to each other. You know, the chemistry was there, whatever the case be, but he could have pulled back just a little bit to figure out things first. You know what I mean? And we all had that fall at least one time. And everybody speaks from experience because you've been there before. And I feel the roles were reversed.
Yeah. I can agree.
Right?
I felt Nina was the dude. I like the movie as far as like the creativeness of that
Right.
movie. And I feel like,
It was shot well too.
yeah, it was shot so well and it was
Yeah.
shot beautifully.
Yeah.
And I feel like I love that it was just a story of two people and like not necessarily black people, but
Right.
at the same time, it was really black.
Yeah.
Like when they went Chicago stepping,
Yeah.
that was, you know, it was
You just
just
talking about your
so.
mom and dad doing that back
Yeah,
in the
my
day.
mom and dad, Chicago stepping back in the day, they used to get down.
You look good.
Thank you.
Yeah,
Oh
you look real
God.
good. So what made me even go further? So our first conversation as well, do you remember when I was straightforward with you?
Yeah.
And you called me what? Intense.
You are intense.
I mean, that's just my energy though.
Yeah,
I'm serious.
you're an intense individual.
I mean, when you go through things in life, you know, you want something serious when somebody coming your way. You don't know what somebody bringing.
True.
You know, so I wanted you to know as well that I wasn't playing no games. You know, but you handled it. Here we are now.
And I let you know where I was.
I mean, you did. You sure did. But I accepted it.
I
You kept it
was
real though, so that's how I respected you more though.
Yeah, I
You
was
know,
honest. I
because
was like,
a lot of ladies be
well,
kind of like, oh yeah, I ain't dating nobody. Nobody around. No, I've
no,
been single.
I let you know, like I'm in a different vibe, confidence wise. Like I'm dating, like I, you know, am out here, you know what I'm saying? Like, but after a couple of just days of us talking, I was like, I don't need to talk to nobody else.
So when was it for you that you knew that, okay, this dude was solid, Was it when you first finally actually got together?
I think it was when we first got together, like when we first hung out.
Okay.
And like you were around my whole family and you were around all of my close friends.
Yeah.
That was a lot for you to walk into, but I did that, kind of did that on purpose.
See how petty you are?
No, that's not, it wasn't petty.
That's what I'm talking about. See, that's what I'm talking about.
It wasn't me.
So no, you set me up.
No, it wasn't me being petty.
Okay, what was
it? I need you to know that I have never brought anybody that I've dated around all of my family and friends.
Okay.
Even my mom, like after sitting talking to you, my mom was just like, do you feel like this is it? Mm-hmm. And that was just like, she's never done that before.
Yeah.
She usually is really tight-lipped if she's met anybody that I've dated. But she definitely was like, what do you feel? Like, do you think this is it? And I was like, Mom, I really do. I really do. Because I knew that there was like, you know, a little rough around the edges. You know what I'm saying?
You know, I'm a real
you're
one.
I'm a real one. Around the edges. But I felt like you're exactly.
Don't try to play me though.
I'm not. I'm rough around the edges too.
Oh, you be honest.
But I mean, feel.
You know
what?
I'm chill. No, I didn't mean to say that. I'm sorry.
Whoa.
I'm sorry. Look at your finger right now. You think it's a real gun, don't you? You're out of control. That's that Compton stuff, see?
You really just tried to
I'm
play
trying
me.
To level you out.
You're an asshole. My favorite scene in the movie had to be when he first did the poem. I'm the blues in your left thigh.
Trying to become the funk in your right. Is that all right?
Oh, that's all right, baby. That's
yeah, it was smooth.
It was real smooth.
It was pretty smooth. I was kind of pulled in myself as a grown man. Like, you know what?
You liked it. You
I
was,
liked it.
You
I'm like, okay, that was flavor right there. It was fire. It was fire. Yeah.
I loved them panning on all the ladies.
All the ladies, yeah.
Because all the ladies was like, whoo. Because words are powerful.
Yeah, and that's what activated Hollywood.
Right. It, no, honestly,
that's what made Hollywood mad.
Yeah. What was your favorite moment? You say yours. What's your favorite moment?
Okay, so for me, I mean, the funniest moment to me was when Bill Bellamy, they were at that little dinner, and he said, if God was a woman, that you know what'll be right here. And that just cracked me up.
Man. Think about this, anatomy. Now, if God was really a woman, y'all know how God think, she'd put the dick right under the chin. She'd take care of her business.
Why?
No,
no, man. No, 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 no. Hey, it ain't.
Yeah, and you get no chips, man.
Y'all sure know how to treat a person.
It was so stupid.
I'm gonna use that.
Why would?
Who thinks of that, first off?
Oh, I get it.
You just, hold on, pause. You just now getting it? Baby, that same time. Oh, so we watched this entire movie. I'm talking about the favorite part.
I literally just got it. I'm slow.
You ain't slow. You just...
No, because I didn't understand...
You're just a good Christian woman.
Shut up.
That's all that is. You're just a good Christian woman. You was in a good space.
I really did. I legitimately did
nah,
not
see why
understand
so
why that
that's
was
why I was
funny
dying laughing.
Right now.
Oh, my God.
Oh.
So, yeah. Both at the same time. Oh, my God.
Oh, I kind of hate myself right now. No, I thought it was like a guy thing. I didn't... Because you were cracking up at that part, and I was like, that's stupid. But now I get it. A lot of guys do neglect. Okay, anyway. Moving on.
So I'm about to ask you a question. So when you think about the movie, right, I got to go back to Darius in Hollywood.
What's up, D? What?
I would have whooped Hollywood's ass.
You embarrassed the shit out of me, and I don't appreciate it. Now, if you and Darius want to see whose dick is bigger, you can do it without me.
Like you didn't think for one second he was going to be at this party.
Are you going to take me home or not?
Walk!
Now, you see how upset I got at that? I'm like, eating my boys is guy code. Yeah. I don't want you no more. You. And then she tried to, in the movie, she's like, do you think I slept with Hollywood? You did. You definitely did. That's why he didn't want to know.
He didn't ask.
Right? So he was in that, he was trying to, you know, keep that,
deflect,
that bliss.
Yeah.
He was trying to keep that bliss, right? So I'm asking you, is it the same for women? Would women be okay with that?
No.
Okay, why not?
Because It's girl code too.
Okay.
It's just like his guy code, it's girl mm-hmm. code. I think that what was really messed up about that is that Hollywood was clearly jealous of him.
Yeah.
Like when he got up on that stage and did that poem, had all them girls open, mm-hmm. Hollywood was bothered.
He wanted to be that guy.
And he wanted to be that guy. And so he went after who Darius wanted.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that you're not a real friend if you do something like
that. Yeah.
Like it's different if
he hate her.
But what if they really hit it off and those two didn't hit it off, but their chemistry was really
It's
good.
Called communication. Like, so, you know, I have some homies that actually crossed women before, mm-hmm. but they had the communication like, hey, bro, you cool if I talk with whoever? Right. And he was like, all right, yeah, you know what? I'm good. That was in the past. But you got to have a respect. Hollywood had no respect.
He didn't.
He was purposely jabbing at him, mm-hmm. bringing her to events.
He also drives a hearse.
So. And he drives a hearse.
This nigga said. Girl, but it's a Cadillac.
Killing me.
Like that Matt made it better.
There's some benefits to this car. I'm telling you.
So how did you feel about Darius' response when, you know, Nina's homegirl called saying that Nina was going to New York for the, was it Vibe?
Oh, when she went to the train. I mean, I think the friend was actually trying to help at this point. I think he had a mark for going and chasing her through the train
station. Okay, so tables turn, right? Let's say if that was one of my homeboys calling, would you have went?
No.
Okay, so his response to Nita's friend, how he was so pissed off,
mm-hmm.
right? Because like, why are you calling me? It took a little bit for me to catch on to them. Like, oh, that's homegirl, that's set up.
Yeah.
Nina in Hollywood.
Yeah.
You know, so I probably would have went.
You would have?
Yeah.
Why?
Just for my own clarity.
I wouldn't have gone because, like, you made your decision.
I mean, but they kind of had... No, he made his decision.
She made hers.
But he did her... Like, he kind of, like, told her to get out my house, get my keys.
Yeah.
Yeah, get out my crib. Don't let the door hit you behind you.
Shut my door all the way when you leave.
Right, he had an ego behind him as well, so I feel that he could have did a little better in that aspect as well.
Okay, I'll give you that.
Yeah? You still wouldn't went?
No.
You're so petty. It's ridiculous. Oh my God.
I'm not chasing nobody down.
I feel you on that.
I'm just not. I'm not doing it. I don't like running. You know that.
How I feel that it could be how Black love is like revolutionary is because I think we're coming along far as learning how to communicate better, mm-hmm. learning how to drop ego. I think a lot of Black people are catching on with therapy and learning how to connect with themselves and release past traumas that we weren't aware of. That you so, why you smiling so
because
hard?
That was just so sexy. Yes.
I got lipstick on me now. God,
talk therapy to me, baby. Yes.
Yeah, but I feel that we advancing as people now, you know, mm-hmm. and I feel that in the past, it was kind of hidden from us. Mm-hmm. You know, we were responding out of instinct and not understanding where it was coming from or cause. You know, I think with social media, you know, people out there speaking publicly, actually making things aware for us, I think we're starting to catch on a little bit.
One thing that I've learned with you 100% in our relationship that I try to talk to my girls about, because, you know, most of my girls, we girl bosses. Like, mm-hmm. most of them work for themselves.
Right.
And have trouble dating.
Mm-hmm.
But I always don't lose that vulnerable side.
Yeah.
That's the one thing that I have learned in being with you is like, I have to be vulnerable with mm-hmm. you. I can't do everything on my own.
Mm-hmm.
I have to let you step in and like be my partner, tell me the truth, rebuke me if I need to be rebuked, you know what I'm saying? And let you love me when I need to be mm-hmm. loved and just be like, babe, I ain't got it. I just don't have it today. I'm not feeling it today, and I need help, you know? I think we can be honest and say we've been damaging to one another in our relationship before.
Mm-hmm.
Not understanding, not being vulnerable, and not
mm-hmm.
giving one another the respect that each mm-hmm. other deserves, mm-hmm. or using that same vigor that we may have to use outside of our home, in our home.
Mm-hmm.
And it's caused problems, but...
But that strength got us through.
We're doing it. We're doing it now, baby.
You know the handshake?
Okay. The
handshake.
Ha 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 ha.